فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد بإذن الله الكريم today we're going to be going through the explanation of the kitab or it's the beginning of the explanation of a book called آداب البحث والمناظرة and it's written by لطاش كبري. His name is Tash Kubrizadeh. So inshallah ta'ala, Abu Issam al-Khair is also known as. I'm not going to be speaking about the author today. Nor will I be speaking about, or nor will I be going through the book today. Today I'm going to be giving you a muqaddimah, an introduction into this field called علم that is known as علم الجدل علم البحث والمناظرة. So today inshaAllah ta'ala is going to be a very long introduction before we go into this book so we can have a good understanding why are we studying this subject for. Is it a newly introduced subject? Is it something that was known by the pious predecessors and etc. Questions you might want to ask yourself or that you might ask yourself. So inshallah ta'ala, the way I plan to go through it is that I will be speaking about ilm al-jadal and matters related to that, and then I'll speak about ilm al-adab al-bahth wal-munadara. So you have a good understanding. So when we go into the book, we just explain the book and we'll do that on Saturday and Sunday inshallah ta'ala. So I start by saying muqaddimah, introduction on ilm al-jadal. Introduction pertaining to ilm al-jadal. Ilm al-jadal. Jadal means, in the language, it means امتداد الخصومة ومراجعة الكلام بين متكلمين في مسألة يختلفان فيها. It basically means, in the lexical meaning, debate. Dialogue, discussion. It's basically two opponents, two individuals. They are throwing at each other, back to front, or back to forth, words in a particular matter which they differ on. So there's two individuals, there's a concept which they're not agreeing on with each other on, and one is saying something, the other one's bringing a response to it, and then that's how it's going. Ilm al-jadal, my beloved brothers and sisters, it's an ilm, it's a knowledge that the scholars previously gave importance to. Naam. The awa'il, the early generation, they gave importance to it. And they wrote many books regarding it, so we're going to leave that to the later points, inshallah. There are many extensive books written in it. And some of the people, they've become so heedless about it. Even that it was important. And they gave no importance to it. And my beloved brothers and sisters, Jadal is not ilm which is mustahdath. It's not a newly invented science where it just came about now. No. Rather, Jadal is present in the Quran. And it's also present in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Quran mentions munadharat, debates that take place. It talks about munaqashat, discussions and dialogues that are going on. You find verses and inshallah we'll bring some. The companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between themselves, there are many debates and discussions. And so inshallah ta'ala, we're going to study in this science, ilm al-jadal, what it's about. And it is, without a doubt, it's a type from the types of shura. Ilm al-Jadal falls under, it falls under Shura. As Allah said in the Quran, وَأَمُرْهُمْ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ. And between them their affairs is Shura. Shura is a, because the leader or the person in charge or the people who want to elect an individual may not all agree. So there comes a Jadal and discussion, and that's what Shura is. And it falls under that. Technically it means, and this is a definition that you would find Abu Sulaiman, so Abu al-Walid Sulaiman ibn Khalaf al-Baji rahimahullah in his Kitab al-Minhaj, Abu al-Ma'ali al-Juwayni rahimahullah in his al-Kafiyah, and Ibn Aqil al-Hanbaliyyu, and Ibn Hazm in his Kitab al-Ihkam fi Usul al-Ahkam, all of them roughly say the definition is تردد الكلام بين مختلفين. It's basically back to forth in speech between two people who are opposing one another. يريد كل منهما, each one wants تصحيح مذهبه وإبطال مذهب خصمه. And each one wants to prove that his belief or what he's holding on to is right, and he wants to destroy and nullify the view held by his opponent. That's what he wants to do. And so that's what debate's about. Is there a difference between munadara, jidal, mujadala? According to the definition of the ulama, Abu Mu'ali al-Juwayni rahimahullah, he says no. He says, فَإِنَّهُ بِأَنَّهُ لَا فَرْقَ بَيْنَ الْمُنَاظَرَةِ وَالْجِدَالِ وَالْمُجَادَلَةِ فِي عُرْفِ الْعُلَمَاءِ بِالْأُصُولِ وَالْفُرُوعِ. He says, there is no difference between munadara and jidal and mujadala. So we have three words now. We have al-munadara, and we have al-jidal, and we have al-mujadala. He says all three of those words, في عرف العلماء, according to the definition of the scholars. So it's a technical definition he's talking about here. بالأصول والفروع, the scholars of أصول الفقه, and the scholars of fiqh, or the scholars of the fundamentals, and the scholars of the sub-branches, they don't differ amongst themselves. There's no difference for them in it. وَإِنَّمَا الْخِلَافُ بَيْنَ هَذِهِ الْكَلِمَاتِ فِي اللُّغَةِ. Where the difference lies is in the lexical meaning or the linguistic meaning. أَمَّا فِي الصِّلَاحِ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ, he says, فَهِيَ وَاحِدَةٌ. As for the definition according to the scholars, then it only means one. So we've taken two things from this. First of all, we've learned what the definition of jadal means. Second thing we've also taken is that jadal and munadara and mujadala, they all mean the same. We've also taken a fourth point, that this science, it's not newly invented, it's not something new. Rather, what it is that it's something that is taken from the kitab and the companions of the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. They debated and they discussed. Rather, debate and discuss can be said, it's basically a human thing. We've always been debating, we've always been discussing. So what's the benefit? Before we go into the benefits, before we do, there are other sciences that are connected to ilm al-jadal. So what we need to do is distinguish those sides from one another, so we're purely left with ilm al-jadal, which is what we're talking about now. So what's the difference between ilm al-jadal and ilm al-munadara? Are they both the same or are they different? According to Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni, for him is what? It's the same. And that's the opinion that he holds. Okay? Some scholars, they distinguish between the two. They say ilm al-jadal is more of the theoretical side of it. It's basically the more of the theoretical side of the study. Whereas al-munadara is actually, it's amaliyah, it's more of an implementation. A person is actually going to go and he's actually going to implement the theories that he learned. So whilst it is theory, it's jadal. And when it becomes implementation, it becomes munadara. That's a qawl that some mention. ولذلك الإمام العلامة محمد الأمين الشنقيطي, he authored a book called Adab al-Bahth wal-Munadara. Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti wrote a book, Adab al-Bahth wal-Munadara, debate. We'll speak about that book inshallah ta'ala, since it's got a very close relationship with the book where we're going to study. This book written by Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti rahimahullah, if you look at it and you read it, it's ilm al-jadal. So what you find is that to him, jadal al-munadara is no different. Because he named the book Adab al-Bahth wal-Munadara, and when you look at the book, the content in it, and you read it, he brings jadal in it. So to be here, to him again, just like Abu Ma'ali al-Juwayni, ilm al-jadal and ilm al-Munadara both mean the same. There's another science which also is kind of related to, or it's dealt with when speaking about ilm al-jadal, which is ilm al-mantiq. Ilm al-mantiq. And ilm al-mantiq is logic and rationality. That's what it is. Ilm al-mantiq is logic. It's basically the path. Ilm al-mantiq is basically more of the path which you take, and ilm al-jadal is more of the what? Ilm al-jadal is more of the qawa'id, the principles that you're going to take. So ilm al-jadal is qawa'id al-munadharat wal-munaqashat. It is the principles in how the discussion and the dialogue goes on that's taking place between the two individuals. Whereas ilm al-mantiq is meant by طرائق معرفة الأشياء, the path and the way to know these things. In other words, علم المنطق more deals with the definition of things. What is meant by this? What's the path? Okay, terms. They really have something called القياس المنطقي, which inshallah ta'ala we will leave for the book سلم المنورق في علم المنطق written by الأخضري. There's another thing called علم الجدل and علم الكلام. علم الكلام. علم الكلام, it really only connects to عقيدة. علم الكلام is, when you hear علم الكلام, it means ما يتعلق بالمسائل العقدية. It's connected to things that are عقيدة related. So what the scholars, they say, علم الكلام, they intend by that علم العقيدة. And the aqeedah here, ilm al-kalam, is actually taken from, and the scholars rebuked it, because their knowledge of aqeedah here, even though it only deals with aqeedah, where it's taken from, ma'khudhu min al-umam al-ukhra, it's taken from other nations. It is taken from the Yunan, it's taken from the Greeks. They take it from the Greek logians. And they introduced it into the religion. And that's the path in which they prove God's existence. So they prove that through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His Qur'an and Allah's characteristics and attributes. As for if you base your aqeedah on al-adillat al-sahiha, the authentic evidences, such as the kitab and the sunnah, then this is what? Then here it is what? Tariqatu salaf al-ummah. That's not the... So when the scholars are rebuking ilm al-kalam, they're not rebuking it because they are against aqeedah. No, they're not. But rather, the ilm al-kalam, which they use to come to speak about aqeedah with, is based upon a source where it's taken from the umam al-ukhra and other nations. What's the ruling, now that we've understood the differences between... now that we've understood the difference between... ilm al-jadal and other sciences. The question is, what's the ruling of debating? Debating is two types. The first one is called jidal bil-haq, debating with truth and haq. And what this means is that every debate in which the person wants to reach the truth and the evidences that are being used are completed are completely taken from the authentic sources. So the Kitab and the Sunnah, and the Aql that the list does not oppose the Kitab and the Sunnah. And also, the person does it in a good manners. وَالْتَزَّمَ فِيهِ بِالْآدَابِ الشَّرْعِيَّةِ The person is in accordance to the etiquettes and the manners which the Sharia has set. And this, my beloved brothers and sisters, this type, which is الْجِدَالُ بِالْحَقِّ, it's actually requested and it's needed. And it's a means from the means to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why you find in many places in the Qur'an, you would actually find that you're commanded to do this. And those who come with it are praised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Qur'an, He says in Surah Al-Nahl, ayah 125, اُدْعُ إِلَىٰ سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِظَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ Allah says, call to the path of your Lord with wisdom, وَالْمَوْعِظَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ and good reminder. Then Allah says, وَجَادِلْهُمْ debate them. بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ with that which is good. So debate with them in good. So here, وَجَادِلْهُمْ is a, it's a command. It's an amr. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah also said, وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, He says, do not debate the people of the scripture إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ except with that which is good. When you do debate them, you debate with them that which is good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions to us and He tells us from the people of Nuh, Nabiullahi Nuh's people, that they described Nuh as to be a debater. فَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah says, قَالُوا يَا نُوحُ أَوْ نُوحُ قَدْ جَادَلْتَنَا You have debated with us and argued with us. فَأَكْثَرْتَ جِدَالَنَا فَأَتِنَا بِمَا تَعِدُنَا You've increased in the debate with us. So come with us with what you have promised. إِن كُنْتَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ If you are from those who are truthful. Surah Hud, Ayah 32. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He praised a woman that debated with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the matter of dhihar. The matter of dhihar is when a man says to his wife, you are like my mother to me. There was a woman, her husband said this to her. And so she debated with the Messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah praised her in the Qur'an and He said to her, قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَاوُرَكُمَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ In the first ayah, Surah Al-Mujadala, Allah says, قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ Allah has heard. قَوْلَ الَّتِي The statement of the woman, تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا Who debates with you, Muhammad, and argues with you in the affairs of her husband. وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ She claims, she complains to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَاوُرَكُمَا And Allah hears the dialogue that's taking place between the two of you, her and the Prophet. إِنَّ اللَّهَ Verily Allah is سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ One that hears and the one that sees. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى Allah also says, رُسُلًا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنذِرِينَ لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى اللَّهِ حُجَّةٌ بَعْدَ الرُّسُلِ Allah also tells us that the Prophets are what? They are رُسُل, messengers. مُبَشِّرِينَ They come with glad tidings. وَمُنذِرِينَ And they are warners. Why are they doing that? لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى اللَّهِ حُجَّةٌ So the people don't have no proof against Allah the Day of Judgment. So the Prophet's job is to convince the people, explain the points to them, discuss and have dialogues with them, okay? Establish the proof on them. Whether they accept it, that's not their job. But for them is to really clarify the matter, even if it reaches a point to debate and to argue with them. So the nation, the prophets were sent to their nations with clear-cut evidences. So they debated their nations. And their nation, they were lost of words. فَانْقَطَعَتِ الْحُجَجِ Their way, the prophets were arguing and they were bringing their evidences forward. Their nation was not able to respond back to them. And that's why many of them actually resulted to actually wanting to kill those prophets or even swearing and belittling them and rebuking them And this is the path of the misguided groups, that when they can't take the debate, they turn it personal. They take it to heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says about Ibrahim. Allah says, وَتِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتٍ مَنْ نَشَاءُ. And here is Ibrahim, we gave him our proofs. Allah said, we gave Ibrahim proofs. عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ, on his people. نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتٍ, we raise who we wish. مَنْ نَشَاءُ. مَنْ نَشَاءُ means whoever we wish. Allah said, we raise them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ibrahim here, he came with clear-cut proofs, was what? He debated with them. He brought the explanation, explained the textual evidence for them. He did everything, and when it came to it, he actually debated with them. And you know the well story of Ibrahim and Namrud ibn Kana'an. Namrud, he claimed that he was a god. And Ibrahim, Allah said about him, أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ أَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ إِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ ربي الذي يحيي ويميت قال انا احيي واميت قال ابراهيم فان الله ياتي بالشمس من المشرق فاتي بها من المغرب فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين. In this verse Allah tells us that Ibrahim argued and debated in the affairs of his Lord. This man was claiming that he was a god. Ibrahim said to him, my Lord can raise, so if you're God. إذ قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يحيي ويميت. Allah is the one who gives life and the one who kills. Then the man goes, أنا أحيي وأميت. I can give life and I can give death. Then Ibrahim said to him, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ. Now the what Ibrahim is doing from bringing this point and then moving on to the other point, we'll study that in علم الجدل. What he just did here. There's a method that he just used. And this is from the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a wahyu min Allah, but it's a science that Allah, that the scholars took from the Quran and how they were applying it. So Ibrahim said to him, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْتِي بِالشَّمْسِ مِنَ الْمَشْرِقِ فَأْتِي بِهَا مِنَ الْمَغْرِبِ فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ. So Allah, Ibrahim told him, okay, bring the sun out of the opposite side. Are you with me? To what it is. Then Allah told us, he was unable to. فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ. He was lost of words. He didn't know what to do. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Also, the Prophet ﷺ tells us in the hadith of Bukhari and Muslim, he said, احْتَجَّ مُوسَى. Nabiullah Musa, ihtajja Adam wa Musa. Adam and Musa both debated. فقال موسى, Musa said, يا Adam أنت أبونا, you are our brother. Sorry, you are our father, sorry. You are our father. خيبتنا وأخرجتنا من الجنة. You've let us down. Because of you we came out of Jannah. فقال له آدم عليه السلام. Adam responded. This is a dialogue now. This is a munadara. It's a debate going between the two of them. So Nabiullah Adam alayhi salatu wasalam said, Anta Musa istafaka Allahu bi kalamihi. You're Musa. Allah chose you with his words. Wa khatta laka bi yadihi. And Allah wrote it on his hand for you. Meaning Tawrat. Allah actually wrote it with his own hands. Atalumuni. Are you blaming me? Ala amrin qaddarahu Allahu alayya qabla an yakhluqani. Are you going to blame me for something Allah destined, he writ, before he created me 40 years? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sorry, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, فَحَجَّ Adam Musa. Adam, he won in the debate. He beat Musa in the debate. So the Prophet said this, فَحَجَّ Adam Musa, فَحَجَّ Adam Musa, twice. The reason is because Nabiullah Musa, he used as the evidence the sin of Adam, which is taking him out of Jannah, or him be taken out of Jannah. And Musa didn't, had no rights to do that. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam explained to him that the masa'ib, the calamities are written and destined min Rabbil Izzati, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is not permissible for somebody to use calamity and blame it to you. Are you with me? Now Musa and Ibrahim are not, sorry, Musa and Adam, their discussion is not about the sin. And Adam is not justifying his sin, like we find people do today, who want to say Allah made qadrullah ma sha fa'al. La, the thing that they're talking about is the calamity of being taken out of Jannah. As for the sin, then that's not what they're talking about. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he really explains that. And he makes sure that that point is understood very well. So that's the first type of debate. The second type of debate is called al-jidal bil-batil. It's a debate based on falsehood. And it is the debate that has lost the characteristics of a correct debate. That is what we mentioned before. It's not using correct and authentic evidences. It's also lost, and it doesn't have adab min adab al-jidal bil-haq. The manners of debate is not also there. Or basically, the person's intent is not to give victory to the truth. The person's actually doing it, his intent is intisar al-batil, to give victory to the falsehood. That's what he wants. And that's why, my beloved brothers and sisters, it becomes clear the importance of actually learning ilm al-jadali. Because it's through ilm al-jadali it becomes clear to you the distinguishing factor that's between al-jidal al-mamduh, the debate and the argument that is actually praiseworthy, and the debate in which the person who's coming with it is blameworthy. There are many evidences that have come speaking about this type of debate, which is al-jidal bil-batili. As Allah said in the Quran, ha antum, here you are. هَؤُلَاءِ جَادَلْتُمْ عَنْهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Here you are debating in a matter pertaining to this dunya. And what this ayah, so the seventh nuzul of this ayah is in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 109. You can say Nisa if you wish to, and you can say Nisa if you wish to. Both ways are correct of saying the word. This ayah, the sabab al-nuzul, the reason behind it was a group of munafiqeen, and the qawm min al-munafiqeen, a group of hypocrites, they stole an armor. Saraqu, they stole dir'a min al-duru'i, they stole a armor from the armors that were there. Then a group of people came from their families, their members, those who stole. Their relatives came, and what they did was they argued for them. And then what they were trying to do was they were trying to say that these are not the ones who stole, and they're not the ones who took it. Rather, it's the Jews that are the ones that took it. So they wanted to shift the blame on the Jews. So the ayah came down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to them, "Ha antum ha'ula'i jadaltum 'anhum fil hayati dunya." Allah is saying to them, in this world, you are here debating for them. But فَمَنْ يُجَادِلُ اللَّهَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the day of judgment, who's going to debate with Allah? Because عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ, he knows the real what really took place. And what actually happened. But you guys might debate for them and argue for them. So the truth is that people who argue for falsehood, that's the ayah that's read on them. هَأَنْتُمْ هَؤُلَاءِ جَادَلْتُمْ عَنْهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا فَمَنْ يُجَادِلُ اللَّهَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. When the day of judgment comes, and your debate is falsehood, it's null and void, and you're debating that which is even true. It's not textually true in the sense, the evidences from the Quran and Sunnah are not in agreement with you. Nor is rationality and logic in your agreement with you. Are you with me, brothers? Then, how are you going to debate in front of Allah the Day of Judgment? And what are you going to say to Him? وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah also says, وَيُجَادِلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالْبَاطِلِ لِيُضْحِطُوا بِهِ الْحَقِّ. Allah says in Surah Al-Kahf, Ayah 56, the disbelievers, وَيُجَادِلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, the kuffar, they debate. But they debate with what? بِالْبَاطِلِ, falsehood. The debate is built upon falsehood. As Allah says, لِيُضْحِطُوا بِهِ الْحَقِّ, and what they want is they want to nullify and destroy the truth. That's what they really want. They want the truth to go and vanish. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَجَادَلُوا بِالْبَاطِلِ, they debate with falsehood. لِيُضْحِطُوا بِهِ الْحَقَّ فَأَخَذْتُهُمْ فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عِقَابِ. In this ayah, which is in Surah Ghafir, ayah 5, the same meaning that was mentioned in the previous one. Also Allah says, يُجَادِلُونَكَ فِي الْحَقِّ بَعْدَمَا تَبَيَّنَ. They are here debating with you in the truth after it became clear to them. They're still debating with you regarding it. Also Allah, which is in Surah Al-Anfal, Ayah 6. Allah said in Surah Hud, when Nabiullah Hud was debating his people, he said, Allah said in the verse, أَتُجَادِلُونَنِي فِي أَسْمَاءٍ. Are you going to debate with me? Nabiullah Hud is saying to them, فِي أَسْمَاءٍ. Are you going to really debate with me in names you guys have elected? You guys have chosen these names. أَسْمَاءٍ سَمَّيْتُمُوهَا أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ مَا نَزَّلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ. You're here making idols up. You're the one who invented this. You've put this forward, and here you are debating with me regarding it. Are you going to debate with me regarding that? And who is the one who named these idols and brought these idols with names and gave them this? Antum, you guys have. Wa aba'ukum, and your forefathers. Man is Allah biha min sultan. You have no proof from Allah regarding it. You have no hujjah that if I was to tell you to go back to and to bring it forward regarding your claim, it would only be that my father said and his father said and his father said. And there are many others in the Quran, extensive. And it's also the one that you find in Musnad Imam Ahmed, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, مَا ضَلَّ قَوْمٌ بَعْدَ هُدًى. A people do not become misguided after guidance have come to them. كَانُوا عَلَيْهِ إِلَّا أُوتُ الْجَدَلِ. Except debate is given to them. In other words, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes a person out of guidance, what you see is that they turn towards argumentation. That the person turns towards debating. And you find that a lot. And wallahi, when I looked at this hadith, I was pondering over it. The people who leave Islam, don't just leave Islam. They turn around and they direct their efforts in debating regarding Islam. So why is it that you really want to debate about it all the time? If you've chosen to leave, why is it that you want to debate it all the time? Why is it that you want to prove it to be wrong? Why is your juhud, your efforts directed at it? Sah? Unless in your heart, it's not fully settled in, that what you're upon right now makes sense. And there's an idea which you have to really understand, is that discrediting something sometimes gives you comfort. It does. Now, in order to feel good, you can't feel good as an individual, know that you Islam is good in your eyes, and you walked away from it. You're going to die in a state of pain and agony. So what you have to do is, you have to deform it, and what do you call it? Deframe it, and make it look bad, and alienize Muslims and Islam. And then you feel better. And that's how every nation works towards their prophets. In order to feel good that they are not going against, that they are going against their prophets, they would first have to make him look bad. And once he looks bad, and he looks evil, then you've got a justified reason in your heart of why you've turned away from him. That's one of the reasons why they directly attack prophets first, before they actually attack the message. They don't really even speak about the message. They never do. They always attack the individual, to discredit the individual, to belittle the individual. And for them, this is because when he drops, and his integrity drops, in their eyes, what he carries also drops. Are you with me, brothers? So as an individual, what you need to understand is that is jidal bil batil. That is the debate and argument that's based on falsehood. The one that doesn't want to face and argue, stick to the point at hand.